everybody. My name is Marcos Casiano, and I'm here to tell you about my adventures on the road, traveling the highways and byways of the U.S. and Canada. And this story actually comes from more of the early days when I was in Nashville. I had moved to Nashville with a friend of mine named Kurt with the objective that we were going to, you know, record an album. We're going to get an agent, and we're going to be based out of Nashville. And we're going to make more money because we're going to be a Nashville act. So we're going to make more money. So somewhere down the line, you know, we put this little band together and we find this bass player. And I had mentioned him in other videos, and his name was John Wesley, or we just called him Big John. He was the bass player for the Holy Molder Rounders. And, you know, he had come to Nashville like a lot of people because he actually wrote songs too. So he was going to try his hand at, you know, the Nashville thing, the Nashville scene. So anyways, we put this little show together with, it was just me, Kurt, and John. We didn't have anybody else. It was just like a trio. And so one day, I don't know where Kurt meets this guy. And this guy's name is Smiling Eddie C. He's like a comical little character, and he actually played guitar, too, a little guitar. And Smiling Eddie C, I don't know where Kurt meets this guy, says, oh, we've got like a showcase coming up where, you know, I'm going to bring these bands in. There's going to be talent buyers there. So you can go there and, you know, you can, you know, these booking agents will be there. And if they like you, they'll talk to you and they'll sign you to the agencies and they'll book gigs for you. So yeah, everything looks fine. So it's going to be at the Roadway Inn, which was off of Briley Parkway. I don't know if it's still there. So we get there. You know, we set up because we had to bring the sound system. That was part of it, the deal. I don't know how Eddie knew we had a sound system. And I remember that day, he goes, oh, do you guys mind taking my guitar with you guys? So he puts his guitar in the van. I guess Eddie meets us later, but we had to bring his guitar in. So we set up and, you know, we're playing. And also on the bill was a singer. He had a hit record. He was a Green Beret. He was Barry Sadler. He had that song, The Green Berets, The Fighting Green Berets. He was there on the show. So I got to back him up that night too. And there was maybe a couple of other bands. I remember there was like a family band there, like a guy with his wife. They had like two or three kids. And I remember they played banjo and did things like that. So everything looked okay. But then I just got that feeling that I don't think there's any talent buyers here. It's like something just kind of feels weird. So, you know, we do our little show. I back up Barry Sadler, this other band. They do their thing. And I just remember there was a lot of military people there, and that's probably why Barry Sadler was there. And like I said, this just looks like it was a party. And Eddie was just looking for free entertainment. And he needed a sound system, and we provided the sound system for him. And we took his guitar to the gig, too. So I remember later that night, we're in the parking lot, and we're loading up. And I'm talking to John. I said, John, I don't think there were any talent buyers here. I think we just got suckered into something. And John looks at me and he says, yeah, the sad thing is I'm just an old sucker. Because John was older than us. He was like probably 35 at the time. He was like 15 years older than me. So it was just one of those sad things you learn. I think these things were kind of common in Nashville because people come to Nashville, they're excited. Somebody has a gig, somebody has an opportunity for you, but they just take advantage of you. So that was a story of Smiling Eddie C, and we had to take his guitar to the gig, and there was no talent buyers there. He just basically, I think, used us for free entertainment that night, and that was the end of it. Never saw or heard from him again. Bye, Eddie.